What is going on, guys? Here's Chuck for Bass Gorilla again. In the last video, I've showed you how I made this bass sound. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a whole drop out of basically one preset you've made. So let's get started. I'm gonna make my money pop like that. So my general process is when I have a cool bass sound, I try to make as many variations of it as I can and want to do. Resample them and from there on work in audio. And that's what I'm going to show you now. So first of all, I'm gonna duplicate the existing bass patch just to have like a safe version where it sounds good already. Because in this process you can really f up the sound and maybe you get something that doesn't really work out. So yeah, always go safe and duplicate the original one. So now we have this bass channel. First of all, I'm gonna create a new audio channel and call it like resampling. Then down here you have this I/O button, which opens like the routing options. There we go for the input. We choose our bass. So every time we record it, it's gonna take the audio from the bass channel. So let's find it here. Bass remake, it's the second one. So then I enable the record function. And yeah. Then basically, first of all, I'm gonna record the first bass sound. So, done. Number one. Then we put this aside, or maybe we put the MIDI over here. And then we're gonna f with the preset we've made. Let's see. This is the fun part, because you can get really creative with it and create sounds you wouldn't normally create, and yeah, just have a safe version of it. So let's see what we can do. Maybe we can turn down the LFO speed at first. So I'm gonna record this. As you wonder how I can record that quick, I've mapped the record button to a hotkey. It's Q for me, and yeah, this way I can really resample pretty quickly. So, second bass sound, let's go. Another cool one. This is pretty cool too. So you can see I'm already just changing a few things and it already sounds pretty different from the original one. So let's see what else can we do. Maybe we can change the cutoff of the filter. That's gonna give a pretty different sound too. Kind of like this echo from the comp filter, so let's resample this. Maybe you can turn the resonance up too, to get a more drastic effect. Kind of cool. Maybe we can turn the resonance of the equalizer up. Let's see what else we can do. Maybe we can turn the feedback from the delay up. Pretty cool sound, but it's not different enough for me. Let's play with the FM. Kind of cool, but now sounds too wide in my ears, so I'm gonna turn the feedback down again. And maybe reduce the resonance on the filter again. Still sounds pretty wide. Kind of cool sound too. Let's record this. Maybe you can play with the octave of the frequency oscillator. Kinda cool. Maybe we can play around with the second envelope, which controls the pitch that we created at the beginning of the tutorial. So now you can see we can get some pretty cool sounds out of this. Just to play with the pitch. Maybe we can even reverse this. Kind of cool. Maybe we can try to get rid of the bandpass filter. This is pretty experimental, but use maybe like another comp or reverb filter to get even a nastier sound. And yeah, play with the speed of the LFO. You can see we get some pretty metallic sound, which is really cool. I love these kind of sounds. These are some cool filled sounds even for later. Even some sounds you wouldn't use normally can be pretty cool for the drop, so. And you can see there's not really a way of doing it. I'm just playing around with really anything I can get my hand on, and yeah, you can be really creative with this. So now for the arrangement, I'm gonna create another audio channel just to have the original sounds above, and yeah, just let them untouched, and yeah, that way I can listen through them and pick the ones I like. I just gonna mute the resample channel And yeah, then we have the drums already playing. So this is the drum groove. And then I'm just gonna try to get a cool groove going. So let's listen for what can be a cool first downbeat bass. So mainly I go for like maybe something more deep and then have like a higher one after that. So we have like a boom boom. Let's see. We had this high layer here. Maybe we can put it here. And the cool thing about Ableton is that if you hold down shift and you have the warping activated, you can stretch them. You can stretch the samples and yeah, change the tone this way. So let's see if we can find something cool. So I want this quicker. So we have quarter notes like this. So that's already cool. I've deactivated the sub for now. We're gonna add it later on. Yeah, cool. Let's go for another sound. Maybe we can go with something like this. Let's see. Maybe something deeper there too. Oh. Oh, so maybe this one can be pretty cool over here. I'm gonna quick fade them so we don't get like a transient noise. And you can see all these sounds are kind of offset because of the LFO shaping and maybe the comp filter and reverb filter. But that doesn't necessarily.
And if you're making last minute dinner plans, you may have a hard time getting in some of the titties in some.
Necessarily mean that this is a bad thing. It just gives it a kind of groove, in my opinion. So I let them as they are. Yeah, I kind of like this one. Maybe we can then put this sound, but make it really quick. And maybe have it like a triplet movement. Let's see. Maybe triplets are too fast for this. Let's go with a. Yeah, that's kind of cool. I like it. Put this down a bit. And then maybe have these rinse and repeat. And then we can switch some of the bass sounds up. We're gonna add this later. Maybe we can change some of these around. Oops. Maybe we can have a pattern like this. I hear something like this. So yeah, that's just my process. I'm just gonna play with it till I get something cool. So we have our first four bars. I'm gonna duplicate this and see if we can have some variations on here. I think in the original one, I've just shows for other bases. Yeah, so we can do something similar here. We have already. Maybe you can put this bass down here and put this bass down here, and then we have like and then we can change up this pattern a bit. That's pretty cool. Let's hear it in context. I'm gonna make my money pop like that. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So I'm gonna group these and call it bass bus or bass group. And we're gonna even post-process them a bit more. So first of all, I'm gonna put another equalizer on there and get rid of the lows again. And for me, the sound can be pushed even further. So I don't know if you're aware of the mid-side OTT, but that's something I like to use a lot. So it's basically a split signal in the mid and the side. And you can do this with a utility in Ableton, and I'm sure there are other ways in other DAWs too. So on the side channel, on the mid channel, we only have the mids, so the width is turned down to zero. And on the side channel, we have the width turned up full way, so we only have the stereo signal. And yeah, then you put an OTT on everything. So you put an OTT on the mid signal and an OTT on the side signal. And I've routed the amount, the time, and the output to macros, so I can control both of them. So now we have pretty drastic values. So I'm gonna turn the output a little bit down. And you can already hear the difference. It's really pushing both the mono and the side signal till its maximum. And yeah, that's pretty cool. So I'm going to put a glue compressor after this just to activate the soft clipping. So it basically just limits the sound to not go over the zero. Let's hear it again. Pretty cool so far. So I'm missing a bit of room that shares kind of all the... I'm kind of missing a room that all the bass sounds are sharing. So I'm gonna put a preset of Ableton on here, which is called Compressed Room Reverb. And this is one of my favorites. So I'm gonna put it after the mid-side OTT probably. Turn down the dry red. I'm gonna play it just so you can hear the effect first. So you can hear this is a pretty drastic reverb effect, but as soon as we turn down the dry red and the room size, we get a nice stereo field. We can try to put it before the OTT too. But as you can hear, it kind of has this weird tail. I mean, we can turn up the timing again a bit. But I think I'm just gonna put it after the OTT. So, yeah, let's see. I have on my master channel, I have a utility where I map the mono button to another key like my record button. So every time I press a button, the mono will be activated, and this is just to check if my sound completely disappears or has like a way less presence in the mono signal, then I probably gonna add some more mono signal to the basses. Let's see. So you can hear it get split down a bit, but it's okay. Which we can do is to put the equalizer in a mid-side mode and just turn up the mid-signal a bit in like a few parts. And yeah, cut down the side, especially the bass, because the low frequencies tend to have the most phasing issues. Yeah, so now this sound is just... So now this sound is just a bit more mono-compatible. So, let's hear it again. Cool. What's now missing is the sub bass, so I'm gonna delete the things I've had here before. And we can basically just go with a normal sub bass. This is my preset I have on here, and we are in the key of G. Let's take a listen. So that's too high. I'm just gonna put like a really long note on here, and you can do this on basically anything. Ableton has this nice pre-made sub bass, which is called hip hop sub bass. This is something I use quite often too, and you can do this with this too. Yeah, kind of cool. So you can hear mine is a bit more distorted because I have this glue compressor on here. Maybe we can put it over here too. And you immediately hear it's pretty cool. Yeah, we can go with this one. So I'm gonna freeze this. And then gonna bounce it out to audio. Because I'm just an audio guy, I like to work with audio, and yeah, you see why. So now I can just align the sub bass with my audio tracks. As simple as it is. So I'm just gonna cut and fade. And then I can duplicate just to have it follow my bass pattern, and later on I can maybe play a bit with the pitch. And you see I'm pretty fast at this already, because that's just the way I work, so you will get a hang of this too if you do this. More often. So, let's see. And now we have our bass following our sounds. Let's hear it in context. Pretty cool if you ask me. So, one thing we forgot is to use this cool fill sound we've made. So let's see, I'm gonna create another channel in my bass group. Let's call this main bass and these fill basses. And then let's see if we can add some cool fill. Sounds like I have some. Okay, because of the drop I've activated here on the hip hop sub bass, we have like a pitch drop, and this kind of sounds weird. So now it sounds better. I've just pressed Control and Shift, and then you can move the sample around on the new Ableton. Otherwise, you would have to change the starting point here. So let's see. Just put it a bit behind. Yeah, sounds good now. Yeah, let's see if we can put some more. Maybe you can put them like this. Let's create another channel because I just want to have some control over it, volume wise. I kind of like how it's filling out the space at the end. Kind of gives it like a cool swipe effect. Maybe we can do this to a few more basses. Yeah, I kind of like this. So, what else do we have? Maybe we can add them to the second downbeat. Make it a bit faster too, and fade it out. Yeah, and I think that's good for the video.